a bit confusing. To say the least. Yes, this is where it came from, and this is what I just unlocked. Oh. Do with this. At least I can get this. That's not quite what I'm looking for. Oh. Of course. There we go. Alright, so that closes that and opens quite a few more things. What? I'm sorry, what? What am I even supposed to do here? This is going to be a bit stressful, probably. Yeah, pretty much for that reason. One miss shot and I'm screwed. This might take a bit of a train. Actually, you know, press the switch. I forgot about that one. Okay. We're getting close, we're getting close. Was going to slow me down the most, isn't it? I forgot that one. I was so close to... That took a while going up. And I guess it could have been worse, but. Take the way to the boss. It's the way to the boss, isn't it? Yeah, that's totally the way to the boss. Is it really just a giant ghost? Thank you. Okay. For a while. Only need one more set of those. Oh, I managed to avoid that. I'm having trouble understanding how am I even supposed to... What? That doesn't work. So now he's actually leaving. Wait for me to get rid, I just have to figure out how. Thank you. That's a lot better. Ah, so close. There we go. Didn't even need to do the last finisher. Oh. That's the boss of the dungeon. Oh, and level up. Look, Shadow from the past. Well, let's see if I made it this time. As in, I made it first this time, hopefully. Aww.
I won! That final part was pretty intense, wasn't it?
Damn it, last one again.
And I thought you'd do well since you figured out the puzzle so quickly. Well, I had a pretty hard time at the last section. Too many of those enemies. That was quite something, wasn't it? A large test space bird is waiting.
Oh yeah, the space bird.
A little spark can grant life to any creature of this world. Yet a most furious thunder will humble those creatures in awe.
Among the fiercest of lightning, you stayed persistent. With calm and calculated waves, you phased through electric discord. You, the traveler, the envoy of change. You have proven yourself worthy. Take this shade, one of a pair, to reach the grand tree.
Purple bolt of shade.
Let your every step form the path of your growth.
Congratulations, Seeker! You collected the Purple Bolt Shade, one of the two shades required to enter the Grand Criskayu. Now that you've collected both of the shades, it is time to take on the final challenge of Gaia's Garden. Take this reward for your accomplishments.
Another circuit overrun.
Good luck and stay vigilant.
I have yet to use a single one of those. Alright, Lauren's done. And done. So that means we're finally ready for that grand something dungeon, right? Mm-hmm. Awesome! This place here is pretty nice, don't you think? I'd like to have a small look around before we continue. Sure, though I have to admit that huge electric stream up there makes me slightly nervous.
It all started when the Orbis, the ethereal god of creation, was born into the emptiness of the world. After pondering for eons in solitude, his desire for company gave birth to the gods of shade. Queen is one of these gods. Born a twin to Gioni. She is the god of the Pentagon, the creator of storms and lightning. Queen is the creator of storms and lightning. Her strong winds keep our world in constant motion. Her fierce thunderstorms are awe-inspiring, sparking curiosity within us. Finally, her little sparks also give life to every creature of this world. Yoni, the creator of ever-flowing waters and twin brother of Queen, was busy filling our planet with oceans and lakes. The water overflowing from the lakes was slowly moving down the hills into the ocean,
However, the water in the oceans was almost motionless. As Queen watched this boring calm water, she had an idea. She created light winds flying over the ocean, creating an abundance of dancing waves on its surface. At first, Yuni did not like this change, as he preferred his water's calm and quiet. But as he saw the creatures playing with the waves and using the winds to travel across the oceans, he reluctantly agreed to keep it. This made Queen very enthusiastic, and so she decided to create stronger and stronger winds, making the waves go higher and higher. This led to the most fearsome storms and tidal waves, including vast amounts of land. Yuni quickly interfered. Queen understood that she made a terrible mistake. To make it up to her twin brother, she created many creatures to live deep within the waters. When the Arrow and the Orbis witnessed the advancements of our kind, they decided to send the message of the sky, wrapped in an envelope of solid broken ice. As he sent out the envelope, the Arrow was ever so careful, only giving it the slightest nudge. After all, the Queen wanted his creation, the earth and mountains, to be damaged when the message arrived. Queen watched the envelope fly towards us, ever so slowly. She watched and watched, growing more and more impatient. She knew that the Arrow wanted to be careful, but if this continued, the message would never arrive in time. Queen then remembered how her kind could withstand the most powerful thunderstorms and fierce hurricanes. She was confident that we could receive a fast approaching message just as well. Without hesitation, Queen reached back and gave the envelope a massive blow, launching it towards us at high speed. It is thanks to her confidence in our resilience that our kind received the message of the sky. And going back. Oh, whoops. Yeah, that's Lanyard, right? I guess there isn't that much to... Oh! They won't even see. Entering the phone, testing your balance. Why? How did he even get there? Oh well. Back to the rite of passage. Wait, something is coming from down there. Okay. Oh, you have got to be kidding! What are weird people again? Seeker, I'm so sorry. I could not stop them. Why? The wickets, they're back already. Some of my people have been attacked. And they're hellbent on shutting down the power plant for real. Hey, Tyler, it's been a while. And you brought a lot of company as well. Oh, you're in trouble. Let me guess, the cats are back. Yes, how do you know? Well, we got them too, right at the power plant. That's terrible. No, that's perfect. I've got them right where I want them. This is the perfect opportunity to research the heck out of these workers, to determine their source, the actual reason for their existence. Spoilers, it won't be the power plant. I wish I had your confidence. Oh, I don't need confidence. I have science! Anyway, Tara, please try to keep your folks calm. I can't have them charge the power plant for the time being. I'll try my best. Seeker! Huh? Why? You have experience in dealing with those wickets, correct? Mm-hmm. Great, follow me this way. I need your assistance ASAP.
Okay.
Yeah, she's the kind that takes your assistance for granted. Still, this might be your only chance to resolve this conflict peacefully. Let's all work together.
I think we have to solve another little quest before entering the last dungeon.
Oh, wait. It would have been too easy otherwise, I guess.
This way, Seeker. There they are. Just ignore them for now. We'll deal with those in a bit. To my office.
Okay.
I'm faster than you. Make yourself comfortable. Comfortable, Seeker. This might take a while. So, we know that the power plant isn't causing this problem. You know why? Because the jungle was already infested when we started building the plant. The shot here seemed to forget about that, but I understand their frustration. Also, these cats, they attack on sight. Normally, subtypes of the same family follow the same patterns. And if they should be hide, they shoot cats, but they don't. It's got me thinking, where have I seen this before? Well, the Bergen mine, of course. The drag itself spawned these little blocks that took over our machinery and integrated it into its temple. So maybe the same thing is happening here. Something is controlling those cats and making them so hostile. I studied those blocks for quite a while, you know, fascinating technology. It used a special frequency and impulses to override systems. Obviously, I extracted both the frequency and the semi-magnetic impulse rate. Where is it? Ah, there you are. And that was easier than I expected. Everything's solid. Let's head outside for the field experiment.